Smith & Williamson Corporate Finance provides advice to entrepreneurs and owner-managed businesses on buying a business, selling a business, and raising finance for a business. For many entrepreneurs, these transactions will be one of the most important things they ever do and one of the most stressful things they ever do. Our role is simply to assist that entrepreneur in making that process as painless as possible. Acquisitions are one of the major destroyers of value in any business. So many people buy first or buy in haste and regret later. Indeed, when you look at academic research on the subject, about 85% of acquisitions are either bad or very bad. On the one hand, they can turbocharge your business. On the other hand, they can destroy your business. One of the most common misunderstandings in making an acquisition is that a good acquisition is a cheap acquisition. A good acquisition is an acquisition that becomes a cheap acquisition. A good acquisition is not simply because you can buy it cheaply. The good acquisition isn't generally about pricing, it's about making the right acquisition. And what is the right acquisition? The right acquisition is a business that fits what you want it to do. It adds something to your business. Its people add something to your business. It's something you understand. It gives you more than what you've got already. If it can add new customers, new supply chain, increase your factory space, then there's something real. But if you're simply making the acquisition because it's cheap or because it adds revenue, that generally is a recipe for disaster. Decide what the strategic value is first, and pricing follows. Don't decide upon the price and then let the strategic value follow. A further key element of making an acquisition for me is to know the target very well. Quite often that people, the first time they really look at an acquisition in detail is perhaps when it's presented to them as part of a process or something like that. And the best acquisitions are at the end of the day of people you've got to know very well and you understand each other, so when you're ready to do a deal, it's less about the price because you've already agreed a meeting of minds, and it's more about the synergies, the values that you hold together, and you becoming what is perceived to be a good home for the new business. The final point is, too many people who make acquisition think the work stops the day they've bought it. The work starts. It's about whether you can make this organisation as part of your company, as part of your culture, so that in the end of the day, in 2, 3, 4, 5 years' time, people understand it as one business. And that way, you will have a successful acquisition.